Heart goes out to the family and friends of these victims.
Right now at 6, we are learning more about the 5 teenagers who died when a car crashed into a pond in Fort Myers. We have some new photos of 4 of the victims: Amanda Ferguson, Brianna Coleman, Eric Cox, and Jackson Ayer. These 4 all worked together at Texas Roadhouse. Tonight, Fort Myers police are investigating how the teens went into the water overnight. Thanks so much for joining us on ABC 7 News at 6. I'm Megan Miller.
And I'm Jeff Harris. The crash happened right along Topgolf Way in Fort Myers. Right now, we're still working to confirm who that 5th victim is. ABC 7's Hope Salmon has been working to get us more on this tragedy all afternoon and joins us live from the scene of that accident tonight. Hope, what can you tell us right now about how the teens are being remembered tonight?
Actually, as you're saying that, it looks like family and friends are walking up right now and dropping off some flowers. They've been doing that all day. There have been parents, friends, family members, coworkers, all going up to the edge of that sidewalk where the car went in into the pond. You can't necessarily see it right here from where we're standing, but if you do go on the other side of the sidewalk, there are tire marks that go into that grassy area, and it leaves that gap that you see over there, and it looks like that's where the car was taken out of the water early this morning. And if you continue walking down, there is another patch that has also been moved where the grass and all of the shrubbery is, and it seems like that's where the car also was maybe hit at the first sight. We're not sure exactly where the car went into the water, but that is what Fort Myers Police Department is working on, getting that information to us. And there's also car parts that are left on that side of the street. So there are flowers that are really deep into that grassland over there as well. And like I said, Fort Myers Police Department is still working to investigate exactly how that car ended up in the pond with those 4 employees that are working at, or we're working at, the Roadhouse, as well as that other victim that died.
Now, Hope, as you just mentioned, we do know that 4 of those victims, they worked together at Texas Roadhouse, and that Texas Roadhouse location about a quarter mile away from where you're standing right now on Danny Drive. Now, you were there earlier tonight at the restaurant. What can you tell us about how the restaurant is remembering these teens?
You can't even go into the parking lot without getting shivers, just seeing the tears, the look on the people's faces. They're all embracing each other and really just trying to comfort each other through this extremely difficult time. When I spoke to the manager there and other employees, they said that they just wanted time to grieve the loss and really just absorb all of this that's happened so quickly for them and their work family. There are more than 200 people inside right now breaking bread, sharing memories, and really trying to heal during this time. And like I said, we did speak to one manager, and they have a message that they'd like to share with all of you.
We've had a lot of them since they were 16, and they've worked with us, and they've moved up the ranks. They know a lot of positions here and are a solid asset for our team and a part of our family. You know, we say it, you're a roadie for life. You know, they wear it on their jackets, on their shirts. I love my job. These 4, they showed that. They loved what they did. They came in with a smile on their face, and, you know, they've probably served the majority of the Fort Myers community.
And like I said, the Fort Myers Police Department is still investigating exactly how the car went into the pond, and those people that have lost their lives are now at the medical examiner's office, and we're just trying to get all of the details here. We'll get that to you as soon as we have that. I'm reporting live in Fort Myers, Hope Salmon, ABC 7.